Maria was in Samoa helping her family who were affected by the tsunami and says she heard many stories of people who weren't receiving aid and witnessed many without enough water, living in makeshift accommodation, swamped by days of rain.
One kid that I spoke to has said that he's been there 7 days, and in the whole 7 days that he's been there, he hasn't once seen food and water come through. You know, that was a concern.
Although she's not happy with the government system of aid distribution, she's still encouraging people to give.
I would still encourage people to donate what they can and to give what they can, but, you know, just ensure that you are using a reputable organisation.
Samoa's Prime Minister disputes Ahoy's claims. He says water is delivered daily to those in need and is satisfied that everyone who needs aid is getting it.
While the Samoan government dismisses claims that the aid isn't getting through, it's pleading with people in New Zealand to keep visiting its beautiful islands. Tourism injects $310 million a year into Samoa's economy, and with 90% of tourism ventures unaffected by the tsunami, the government says one of the best ways to help is to visit.
This is one of the greatest things that you can do to help us in our reconstruction, is to keep travelling to Samoa, keep coming and enjoying the wonderful things that you're used to getting there, the hospitality, the warmth of the people.
Despite some tourist cancellations, many are still choosing to press on with coming holiday plans in Samoa.